There is an overview of the different controls that you have in the Instorier editor. First of all, if you at any point want to go back and edit the global styles, you can do that by clicking this button here, and that toggles the global styles menu. In the middle here, you can see a preview of the elements in your story. We have one section, and in that section, we have one element, which is the title that you see in the middle of the screen right now. You can add a new section by clicking this button here. And you can now see that we have two sections, section 1 that we had before and section 2. By adding the second section, we're now able to scroll through the story. On the right hand side, you can see the highlighted area that shows which section currently is visible. Right now, we don't have any content in section 2. We can add elements by clicking here or by going into the section settings and click the Add New button. This opens the element selection menu, where you can choose between different types of modules that you can use within your sections. These modules include titles, quotes, rich text, images, videos, cards, and more. For now, we'll choose a quote, and when we click it, you can see that we have a quote in our story. On the right-hand side, you're now able to edit the quote text and the quote author, along with some other properties. To get back to the section settings, you can click the X in a corner, that takes you into the section, and if you click X once more, you're back to the section overview. If you want to get a better impression of how a reader of your story is going to experience it, you can click on the full preview mode. That expands the story to fill the entire screen so you can see how it will be consumed on your audience's devices. To get a better sense of how it's going to look on mobile, you can click on this switch here, which takes you into the mobile preview mode. Here we can double check if we need to make adjustments to make the story more appealing on mobile devices. As you've seen before, you can click here to open the section preview. But if you click the button to the right, that opens the background elements panel. These are a special type of elements that live in a background of your content. They can fade in or out based on which sections are visible. To add a background element, you can click the plus button, which takes you into a selection menu of all the different kinds of background elements that we have. You can choose between galleries or videos. For now, we'll select an image. We'll choose an image and upload it. Click the upload button. And when the image is uploaded, we can click outside or on the X to close the image settings. You can now see that you have a new element here that looks kind of interesting. These are a special type of elements that have timelines. You can use these timelines to make elements appear at specific points in your story. When you scroll down a bit, you can see a line that shows exactly where in the timeline you are right now. The green circles that you see here right now, they're called keyframes. And if you follow the gray line, you can see which keyframes are active right now in the story. If we now scroll back to the top, you can see that the image fades out. That is because we have a timeline called opacity. The first keyframe of opacity has a value of 0. You can edit that by dragging. You can make it fully opaque or fully transparent by setting it back to 0. The second keyframe has a value of 1. So it goes from the value of 0 to the value of 1 as we scroll down. If you scroll further down, you can see that the third keyframe has the value of 1 and the fourth has the value of 0. So when we scroll, it goes from 1 to 0. Back up to 1 and to 0 as we go to the top. So by adjusting the keyframes, we can control what happens in our story. If we add another section, you can see that we can change multiple keyframes at once by dragging the bottom keyframe of the colorful timeline. And if we now scroll down, you can see that the image is visible for a little bit longer. If we want the image to be visible when we're at the top of the story, we can set opacity to 1 for the first keyframe. Each background element have multiple timelines. Here's the timeline to adjust the position. If you click on it, you can see that you can adjust the horizontal and vertical position. If you go to the second keyframe, you can adjust the vertical position, and that will make the image move a little bit upwards when you scroll down. If you feel like the image is moving too much, you can go to the second keyframe and reduce the amount that it's moving. This makes the movement a little bit more subtle. And to get a better overview of how your story is going to feel like for your audience, you can click on the full preview mode, which takes you full screen so you can see all the elements together. If you are happy with how your story looks on mobile and desktop, you can publish it. You do that by opening the publishing dialog by clicking here, and when you're ready, hit publish story. You then get back a link and an embed code that you can add to your website. If you want to see the end result immediately, you can click on the link and see the final story. You can also share this link with your audience. When you go back, you can close the publish dialog, and if you're done editing, you can open the navigation menu by clicking the circle in the top right corner. Clicking on all stories takes you back into the site settings. And with that, our tour is complete. If you want to learn more about how to use these tools to create engaging digital stories, you can go to instorier.com/learn or to our YouTube channel. See you soon!